Hallelujah, blessed name of the Lord. Pleasant morning to family and friends, brothers and sisters in Christ. I welcome you today into the presence of the Lord. I greet you in that powerful name of Jesus, our Savior and soon coming King. It's so blessed to be in your company and to have you with us today. And we trust that as we fellowship together and as we minister together, we all will continue to grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that our hearts will continue to be rooted and grounded in Him and continue to trust Him even in times and moments when we cannot trace Him, and to know that we are serving a great God. We are serving a God, hallelujah, who is a miracle working God, a God, my friends, that we can trust, a God in whom there is no failure. Let's continue to lift our hearts unto Him in joyful praise as we continue to exalt His name and seek His divine blessings and His, hallelujah, His peace that passeth all understanding, even in our life. Father, we worship You this morning. You are the King of Kings and You are the Lord of Lords. You are the great I Am. You are all that we need and all that we'll ever stand in need of. So we've come, Lord, this day to worship, to honor, and to magnify Your name. You sit high and You look low and You look even in the hearts of men. And great God, I want to tell You thanks for taking us through another week. I want to tell You thanks for blessing us to behold this day. I want to tell You thanks because, God, we know and we believe in our hearts that You have already prepared a table before us. And Lord, we pray even at this time that, Lord, You will continue to minister to us. You will continue to open doors. You will continue to bless us at our very point in need. And great God, we pray for this entire fellowship. We pray for our country. We pray, oh God, for the entire world. And Father, all that is taking place, it is not strange to You. And God, not even a sparrow would fall to the ground without Your knowledge. And so, Father God, we thank You that You have kept us, You are keeping us, and Lord, You will continue even to keep us. Lord, as I stand to minister Your word even now unto Your people, Lord, I pray that You will unctionize me, You will continue to fill me, You will continue, Lord, to use me as an instrument of Thine. And Lord, as Your word go forth today, we pray that, God, Your word will go forth with power, it will go forth with might, and Lord, Your word will accomplish the purpose for which You will have sent it today. Bless your listeners this morning and continue, God, to minister to us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Thank God to be here. Thank God for you this morning who are privileged to sit under the terms of the gospel. And so I want to share with us even today from the gospel according to St. Matthew and chapter 8, and we look at verses 1 through even under 4. And it reads as follows. When He was come down from the mountains, and that's Jesus Christ, great multitudes followed Him. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped Him, saying, Lord, if Thou wilt, Thou canst make me clean. And Jesus put forth His hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. And Jesus said unto him, see thou tell no man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, and offer the gift that Moses commanded for a testimony unto them. This is the word of the Lord, and we give God thanks for His word this morning. And I want to talk to us a few moments on the cleansing of a leper. We are told this morning, my family and friends, that Jesus had just come down from the mountain, and there was a great multitude that began to follow Him. Now we must remember that anywhere Jesus went, He was doing good. And because of the mighty works that He been doing, there was always a vast multitude around Him. And so oftentimes He would have had to withdraw Himself where He could spend some quiet time with God and even
again fresh strength and courage to continue on his mission. And so peradventure it might have been on such an occasion that Jesus was in the mountain and he came down from the mountain and there was this great multitude. But out of the multitude we are told that the scripture zeroes in on this man that was a leper. And this man came to the Lord Jesus and he beseeched him, Lord, if thou can make me clean. I want to say thanks be to God today for allowing Jesus to come down from that mountain. Had he remained in that mountain, my friends, I would want to believe that that leper would not have had a privilege. That leper would not have been blessed with an opportunity like that. That he could have met with Jesus on a personal basis to receive, my friends, his healing. I thank God that Jesus came down from heaven, that a sinner like me, hallelujah, could have met with him and have experienced a transformation even in my life. And I thank God it's the same Jesus we are serving. Paul says to us in the book of Hebrews, he is the same yesterday, he is the same today, and he is the same forever. And my friends, he does not change. So as he met with this leper, my friend, we are told that this leper cried out, Lord, if thou will, thou can make me clean. The first thing I share with us today, my friend, is consciousness to recognize the great need, my friend, for healing. I oftentimes would say, my brothers and my sisters, that God cannot do for us what we won't allow him to do in our heart and in our life. Had this man not come to the point to recognize that he was in need, my friends, of healing, he could not have experienced the healing power of God, my friends, upon his life. And my friends, it is the same Jesus that is able to heal. We are in a day, we are in a time, my friend, when there are many, my friends, being affected by this COVID-19, by this coronavirus. Some says, my friends, it is not a virus. Some says it's a bacteria. But whatever it is, my friend, it is something that men and women need to be delivered. Amen. So we are saying this morning that thank God, if we have not come to the point to realize it, my friends, we need to believe it now, that we need to be cleansed. We need to be delivered. We need to be pushed, because we all have sin. We have some form, my brothers and my sisters, of complication. There is some form of imperfection in every one of us. This leper among the multitude that was around the Lord Jesus Christ at that moment when he came down from the mountain, the Bible highlights this leper, my friend, and he cried out to the Lord Jesus, Lord, if thou will, thou can make me clean. And thank God, my friends, and there are millions around the world who have life complication, my friend. We all may have it in different ways, but this man, we are told, he was a leper. But may I say to us today, the greatest sickness that we have in the world, my friends, is what is called S-I-N. And Paul in Romans 3 and verse 23 says, for we all have sinned. And in Romans 6:23 says, for the wages of sin is set, but the gift of God, my friends, is eternal life. And John in the epistle says, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. This man came and he cried out to Jesus, Lord, if you will, my friend, you can make me clean. But not only we recognize, my friends, his great need, my friends, for cleansing. There are millions of people around the world who are whole, but they are not all whole according to the Lord Jesus. Oh yes, they are physically fit and running around, but my friends, they have the same complication, which, my friends, is sin. But not only, my friends, his great, you know, need to recognize that he needed healing, but we also recognize his willingness to bow down at Jesus as he cried out, Lord, if you will, thou can make me clean. It would remind me, my friends, even of Zacchaeus, after he had met with Jesus and the Lord Jesus looked upon that sycamore tree in Luke 19 and he says to him, Zacchaeus, come down, for I must abide at thy house. And we are told that Zacchaeus made haste and came down and received Jesus joyfully. I want to say to us, my friends, as this leper came and he humbled himself before the Lord Jesus, it's so the Lord Jesus is willing and ready to heal, to deliver, and to set free. But when we come to him, my friend, we must be willing to humble ourselves before God. And that's why Paul says, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And whilst, my friends, some would see the need, some are not humble enough to understand that they must bow at the name of Jesus for their deliverance. We are told, my friend, that this leper came and he cried out to the Lord, "Lord, if thou wilt, thou can make me clean." God is able. And finally, my friends, we would understand his faith to believe that the Lord Jesus was able, my friends, to deliver him. We are told, my friends, in the book of Hebrews and chapter 11, and beginning from verse 1, it says, "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by faith our elders obtained a good report, and without faith it is impossible to please God. For he that cometh unto God must first believe that he is, and he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." Without faith it is impossible to please God. So this leper had reached that point of belief. He believed that if no one else could have healed him, he believed that that Lord Jesus Christ was able to heal him. Was it, my friend, that he must have heard of some of the miraculous work that was done by the Lord Jesus before? Is it, my friend, that he was among the company while Jesus performed his first miracle, my friend, in Canaan of Galilee at that wedding ceremony? Was it, my friend, that he might have been there in the crowd when Jesus fed the multitude with 2 loaves and a couple fishes that the little lad had offered? Was it, my friends, this man was there when he raised Jairus' daughter that had died? Was it, my friends, that the same man, hallelujah, was there when Jesus stilled the storm, when he told the disciples, "Let us go over on the other side," and while he was in the hinder part of the ship asleep, we are told, my friend, that the wind was boisterous, their lives were in jeopardy, and they cried out to the Lord Jesus. Jesus, we are told, got up. He rebuked the wind and there was a great calm. And the disciples said, "What manner of man is this? Even the wind and the waves obey his voice." But this man, we are told, he believed that the Lord Jesus was able to make a difference in his life. He believed that the Lord Jesus was able to heal him. And so he cried out, "Lord, if you will, you can heal me." I want to say to somebody this morning that Jesus is still the mighty healer. He still has the power to raise the dead. He still has power to cleanse and to transform lives. And whatever might be your complication, my friend, I want to assure you today that the Lord Jesus is able, and he's well able to meet you right now at your very point in need. And we are told that Jesus spoke the word in the life of that man, "Be thou clean," and we are told that that man was cleansed. And then, my friends, we are told that he told that man, "Go and show yourself to the priest and let him offer what Moses commanded." And that was, my friends, although he was cleansed by the Lord, he had to go now and get the clearance certificate from the priest, that the priest was able to say, "Well, yes, you are clean." You see, my friends, we need to understand, God does not contradict himself. God cannot go back on his word. So we are told, my friend, that after that man was healed by the Lord, the word of the Lord says that the Lord Jesus told him to go now and show yourself to the priest. The cleansing of a leper. He recognized his need, my friends, for cleansing. He humbled himself at the Lord Jesus for cleansing. But also we learn that he had the faith to believe that the Lord Jesus was able to do what he requested of him. I want to say to you today,
It's the same Jesus that we are serving. Maybe you have an issue like the woman who had this issue of blood for 12 plus years. And you may have exhausted all possibilities. And there seem, my friends, to be no betterment in your life. I want to invite you today to trust Jesus. Give Jesus that opportunity in your life. And you will see how Jesus can make the difference. You will see that Jesus has the power to heal, my friends, and even to deliver. Whatever it is, my friends, nothing is too hard for our God to do, and He's able. I want to encourage you today to trust the Lord. Think about this leper as Jesus came down from the mountain. And you know what, my friend? He's closer to us even than a brother. There's that beautiful hymn that the poet wrote. It says, "Our Lord who left the heaven, the Lord who left the heaven, our life and peace to bring, to dwell in lowliness with men, their pattern and their king." He's closer to us than a brother. We can tap in. We can appeal. We can reach out to Him. And whatever our needs are, thanks be to God, He's able and He's well able to do it for you. But you must believe. You must recognize your great need for deliverance. And you must be willing to humble yourself even unto Him. James in his epistle says to us, "Humble ourselves therefore under the mighty hand of God, that He may exalt us even in due times." Let's pray today as we give God down. Father, we thank You for Your word that went forth today. And Lord, You said Your word will not return unto You void, but Your word shall accomplish the purpose for which, Lord, You would have sent it. And Lord, we pray that Your word will continue to administer healing. Your word will continue to generate life. Your word, Lord, will continue to bring clarity into the hearts and the lives of Your people. And Your word, Lord, Your word will continue to remain as a two-edged sword that is quick and it is powerful. And God, we pray that, Lord, Your word will continue to rest. Hallelujah. Your word, Lord, will continue to abide in our hearts. That, Lord, as we go from day to day, Lord, we'll continue to trust You. Even in the darkest moment of our life, Lord, we will trust You. And we will know and continue to believe that, God, You are real, You are alive, and You are alive forevermore. Father, we thank You for past blessings. We thank You for present blessings. We thank You for that young man right now that needs deliverance. We thank You, Lord, for that young lady who is perplexed in life right now. We thank You for that man, Lord, who right now has some form of addiction and is looking for help. He's looking for deliverance. God, we pray Your special anointing upon his life, that, Lord, he will come to know You as his personal indwelling Savior. Father, we pray for that woman today. That woman, Lord, that has no real sense of direction in life. And Father, we pray right now that Your strong touch, Your strong anointing will be upon her life. It is Your anointing, Lord, that breaks the yoke. And Lord, who You set free is free indeed. Thank You, Lord, for deliverance today. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Continue to trust Him. Continue to take Him by His word and know that God is able to do it for you. If He cleansed the leper, He is able to cleanse you. If He delivered Daniel from the lion's den, He is able to deliver you, because nothing is too hard for our God to do. God bless you and give you His peace.